acecoach.com presents.
A couple of pieces when we're learning kinesthetically that we need to know. First off, there's three basic ways that we're going to learn feelings. Some feelings are going to add pace to the ball. Some feelings are going to take pace off the ball, and some feelings are going to maintain the pace of the ball. So it's about controlling the speed.
Here's the typical tactic for the hit sensation. Your opponent has sent a weaker, higher ball. You can run around and take it three-quarter court with a shoulder-level forehand.
One of the feelings we have for sensational tennis is to add pace to shots. And the one that we'll look at right now is called the hit. A hitting action is one that's multi-segmented. It's like links of a chain going through a whipping action. And so having all those pieces with that last final piece being maximum speed. So that's a hit compared to if I'm guiding or just stroking a shot. So one of the ways we can learn to feel that is we're just going to trade rackets here. And we use one of the little rackets that you can use for progressive tennis, or quick start as they call it in the States. And because it's smaller, it's a little lighter and you'll be able to whip it a little more. And we'll use the foam balls in order to do this as well. So all I'm going to do is get over here, I'm going to toss the ball up, and he's going to go ahead and go through that whipping action. The key that we're going to look at is the elbow back and then the elbow coming forward first. That allows that hit feeling. So here we go. And let's take it in the air. In the air. That's it. And again. Okay. One more time. And hit. And the idea is, don't worry so much where it goes right now. Just get the feeling of that hitting the ball.
Remember that the hit feeling is a very advanced skill, as it requires the coordination of many segments. The key to the action is to uncoil your body from the ground up. The feeling is like pulling your racket away from a person who'd be holding it behind you.